हाय गाइस, वेलकम टू माय चैनल नॉलेज ऑफ लॉ। और आज हम बात करेंगे पीएचडी के सोल क्वेश्चन पेपर के बारे में, जो कि एमडी यूनिवर्सिटी रोहतक से है। और ये है उसी सीरीज़ का थर्ड पार्ट है। इससे पहले मैं 50 क्वेश्चंस जो है वो डिस्कस कर चुकी हूँ, जिनका लिंक मैं डिस्क्रिप्शन में दे दूँगी। आप वहाँ से जाके उसे चेक कर सकते हैं। और जो भी इस चैनल पर नया है, प्लीज़ इस चैनल को लाइक कर दीजिए, सब्सक्राइब कर दीजिए और बेल आइकन को हिट कर दीजिए। और अब चलते हैं अपनी वीडियो पे, कंटिन्यू करते हैं। क्वेश्चन नंबर 51। विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग आर्टिकल्स ऑफ द यूएन चार्टर इज रिलेटेड टू डोमेस्टिक ज्यूरिस्डिक्शन? ऑप्शन वन आर्टिकल 2 क्लॉज 7, टू आर्टिकल 23, थ्री आर्टिकल 51, फोर आर्टिकल 72। एंड द राइट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑप्शन नंबर वन आर्टिकल 2 क्लॉज 7। कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, द फर्स्ट अरेस्ट वारंट वॉज इशूड बाय द इंटरनेशनल क्रिमिनल कोर्ट इन विच ईयर? ऑप्शन वन 2003, टू 2004, थ्री 2005, फोर 2006। एंड द राइट आंसर इज ऑप्शन नंबर वन 2003। क्वेश्चन नंबर 53। मनीला डिक्लेरेशन 2012 इज रिलेटेड टू? ऑप्शन वन ह्यूमन राइट्स, टू मराइन कोस्ट प्रोटेक्शन, थ्री एयर पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल, फोर इकोनॉमिक इश्यूज। एंड द राइट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन नंबर टू मराइन कोस्ट प्रोटेक्शन। क्वेश्चन नंबर 54। Under which article of UN Charter the Security Council has the power to use the force against a state? Option 1 Article 2 Clause 4, 2 Article 41, 3 Article 42, 4 Article 24. And the right answer to this question is option number 3 Article 42. Question number 55. The real power of appointment of UN Secretary General lies with 1. Security Council, 2. General Assembly, 3. General Assembly and Security Council, 4. The 5 permanent members of Security Council. And the right answer is option number 4. The 5 permanent members of Security Council. Question number 56. New members can be admitted in the UN by 1. Security Council, 2. General Assembly, 3. Secretary General, 4. General Assembly on the recommendation of Security Council. And the right answer is option number 4. General Assembly on the recommendation of Security Council. Next, question number 57. Which of the following doctrines relates to the subject of recognition of state or government? Option 1. The Carter Doctrine, 2. The Drago Doctrine, 3. The Toba Doctrine, 4. The Monroe Doctrine. And the right answer is option number 3. The Toba Doctrine. It's option number 3, guys. Next question. Question number 58. Which chapter of UN Charter is provides with economic, financial and military sanctions? Option 1 chapter 9, 2 chapter 6, 3 chapter 7, 4 chapter 8. And the right answer to this question is 3 chapter number 7. Question number 59. International law also develops through state practices. What is that called? 1. International Treaty, 2. International Committee, 3. International Customary Law, 4. International Morality. And the right option is option number 2. International Committee. Question number 60. The Interpol has its headquarters at 1. Montreal, 2. Bonn, 3. Lyon, 4. London. And the Interpol has its headquarters at Bonn. Option number 2 is correct option. Question number 61. When two or more persons commit some tort against the same person, they are. Option number 1. Independent tortfeasors. 2. Joint tortfeasors. 3. Either independent tortfeasor or joint tortfeasors. 4. Neither one nor two. And the right option is 3. Either independent tortfeasor or joint tortfeasors. Question number 62. The tort of deceit owes its origin to option 1. Paisley versus Freeman. 2. Limley versus Gay. 3. Rylance versus Fletcher. 4. Wismore versus Greenbank. And the right answer to this question is Paisley versus Freeman, which is option number 1. Question number 63. The tort of inducement of a breach of contract finds its origin in 1. Limley versus Gay. 2. Rooks versus Bernard. 3. Donogh versus Stevenson. 4. Rylance versus Fletcher. And the right option is option number 2. Rooks versus Bernard. Question number 64. The rule of Ubijus ibi remedium was recognized in 1. Winterbottom versus Wright. 2. Champman versus Pickersgill. 3. Ashby versus White. 4. Rylance versus Fletcher. And the right option is option number 3. Ashby versus White. Question number 65. Damnum sine injuria means 1. Damage without infringement of legal right. 2. Damage with infringement of legal right. 3. Infringement of illegal right without damage. 4. Infringement of legal right with damage. And the right option to this question is option number 1. Damage without infringement of legal right. Now coming to the next question. Question number 66. Injuria sine damnum means 1. Violation of legal right without damage. 2. Violation of a legal right with damage. 3. Damage without violation of a legal right. 4. No damage and no violation of a legal right. And the right option is option number 1. Violation of a legal right without damage. Question number 67. Under the law of torts, the damages are 1. Liquidated. 2. Limited. 3. Unliquidated. 4. Unliquidated but limited. And the right option is option number 3. Unliquidated. Dated. Question number 68. The defense of voluntary non-fit injuria is not available in 1. If the consent is obtained by compulsion. 2. If the consent is obtained by fraud. 3. If the consent is obtained under a mistake. 4. All the above. And the right option is option number 4. All the above. Question number 69. The maxim res ipsa loquitur is a 1. Rule of law. 2. Rule of procedure. 3. Rule of evidence. 4. Rule of negligence. And the right option is it is a rule of evidence. Option number 3. Question number 70. When was the Consumer Protection Act 1986 repealed? Option 1. 2015. 2. 2017. 3. 2018. 4. 2019. And it was repealed in 2019. Option number 4. Question number 71. The term fraud on minority has been first developed and applied in option 1. Meunier versus Hooper's Telegraph Works. 2. Cook versus Dix. 3. Brown versus British Abrasive Wheel Company. 4. None of the above. And it was first developed and applied in Meunier versus Hooper's Telegraph Works. Option number 1. Question number 72. In which judgment the Supreme Court was held that it can exercise its powers under Article 142 to grant divorce on the ground of irretrievable breakdown. It's breakdown, friends, not background. It's a printing mistake, I guess. So, on the ground of irretrievable breakdown of marriage, even though it is not a ground under the Hindu Marriage Act 1955. Option number 1, Ramchandra vs. Anantha 2015. 2, Anil Kumar Jain vs. Maya Jain. 3, Krishna Bhattacharji vs. Sarthi Chaudhary. 4, Dhanulal vs. Ganesh Ram. And the right option to this question is option number 2, Anil Kumar Jain vs. Maya Jain 2019. Question number 73, Section 13B of Hindu Marriage Act 1955 has been inserted in that act by its amendment N. 1, 1956, 2, 1967, 3, 1976, 4, 2006. And the right answer is option number 3, 1976. Question number 74. Which section of Hindu Succession Act 1956 lays down the order of succession among agnates and cognates? Option 1, Section 8, 2, Section 10, 3, Section 12, 4, Section 14. And the right option is Section number 12, option number 3. Question number 75, Schedule 5 of Indian Succession Act 1925 deals with 1, form of certificate, 2, form of caveat, 3, form of probate, 4, form of letters of administration. And the right option is option number 2, form of caveat. Thank you friends for watching the video. अगर आपको वीडियो पसंद आई हो तो प्लीज़ आप इस वीडियो को लाइक कर दीजिएगा और आप अपने फ्रेंड्स के साथ इसको शेयर कर सकते हैं ताकि ये नॉलेज उन तक भी पहुँचे और उन्हें भी अपने PhD में एडमिशन लेने के लिए हेल्प हो। अगर आप मेरी वीडियोस को लाइक करेंगे और मुझे कमेंट करके बताएंगे कि आपको वीडियो कैसी लगी तो उससे मुझे मोटिवेशन मिलेगा ताकि मैं जल्दी ही आपके लिए इसी सीरीज़ का पार्ट 4 लेकर आऊँ जिसमें कि मैं आपके साथ और 25 क्वेश्चंस जो है वो डिस्कस करूँगी जो कि MDU के एग्ज़ाम में आए थे PhD के लिए। तो प्लीज़ इस वीडियो को लाइक ज़रूर करें और अपने फ्रेंड्स के साथ शेयर करें एंड प्लीज़ कमेंट करके मुझे ज़रूर बताएं कि आपको ये वीडियो कैसी लगी और आपको अगर किसी टॉपिक पे स्पेसिफिकली किसी वीडियो की ज़रूरत है तो आप मुझे टॉपिक कमेंट में लिख सकते हैं, मैं उसी टॉपिक पे आपके लिए वीडियो बनाऊंगी। और थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग द वीडियो।